In retrospect, I probably would have done things a little differently.
So as far as you know, as far as this incident's concerned, this is all of it.
This is everything. This is everything.
That might not have been everything after all, though. That was Donald Trump Jr. shortly after the news broke about his 2016 sit-down with a Russian lawyer who promised dirt on Hillary Clinton straight from the Russian government. Now just released transcripts of his interview with the Senate Judiciary Committee provides a fuller picture of the who, what, when, and where of that infamous meeting. So let's dive into it all. So Don Jr. in this transcript says that he's interested in listening. In getting information on Hillary Clinton. Even if it was coming from the Russian government, I didn't know where it was coming from. Regardless, I was willing to listen. Is that collusion?
It's not good. It's a really terrible look. I don't know if it's collusion or not, but there's no legal standard for collusion,
right. But this has been a big question all along.
Well,
this
right, and it's right there in black and white that they were talking to a foreign, hostile government and wanting to take information with them about their opponent. That is problematic. Whether or not they ended up getting anything out of the deal, which they did not in this case, that doesn't matter. What if they had? I mean, then maybe we'd be having a different discussion.
But is that answer to that question, is that everything? The fact that he wanted to get something and they didn't offer it up and they didn't have anything to provide, is that then not collusion?
It was both amateurish to take the meeting in the first place and then to try to explain it away in the way he did. That's a given, though. With that organization and with that campaign, it wasn't a serious presidential campaign like we'd ever seen before. But hey, they won, so you can't fault them for that. Look, I think the American people are getting really restless, though, with what Mueller's got here. And you know, the Senate committees are out now with their reports. The House committees have been out with their reports. I think we've got to get to the end of this thing because, you know, we're headed into the election now. How long is this going to go on for? Are we just going to talk about this for the next 3 years? And we need to know what Mueller's got on this. Is he going to make a collusion charge of some sort or a conspiracy charge of some sort? Are we just going to keep talking about this endlessly?
Well, and this gets to the anniversary quickly approaching, meaning tomorrow, of when Bob Mueller was appointed. That's the only reason that I even recall this anniversary is because Rudy Giuliani told Bloomberg in an interview that they're going to mark this anniversary by trying to build momentum and build pressure to get Mueller to wrap up. I do wonder, though people might be restless, why push Mueller to wrap it up? Why not let him? Why? No one knows what he has. This is the only shop in all of Washington that really doesn't leak. Well, why the pressure? Why? What is it? How does it help Rudy Giuliani and Donald Trump?
Well, you know my position on this. Look, I've spent 38 years in law enforcement and I've done a lot of investigations. What I'm seeing is the longest fishing expedition I've ever seen regarding an investigation.
Fish. There are people who are 23 indictments.
Let me finish, please. Look, you're right. He's caught fish. He's trying to catch the big fish. He's trying to catch Donald Trump, and he's not going to. This recent investigation report that just came out, notice it said meddling, but no evidence of collusion. Now, you have the House saying one thing, the Senate saying another thing, Mueller saying nothing, and you're absolutely right. The people are tired of this. Get it over with. Either you have the evidence or you don't. And if you don't have the evidence by now, you've got a real problem on your hands. So I think at the end of the day, we will find no collusion. Kate, if there was meddling, it doesn't mean that the president or his campaign was participating in that meddling. Probably if there was, it was on the side of the Russians or anybody else who would try to meddle, which isn't, by the way, we know isn't nothing new for Russia. They've been doing this for years. Throughout elections.
I would only say this. None of us know what Bob Mueller has. Right. We found out last week about Michael Cohen pitching himself and accepting payments from companies, yada, yada, yada. Bob Mueller knew about what we found out last week. He knew that 6 months ago and was doing interviews. So God knows what he knows in the 6 months since. We don't know anything. We cannot reach conclusions. We don't, when anyone says there's no evidence of collusion, we can't say yes, no, or anything in between. The Senate and the House now don't agree on the intelligence community's assessment says what?
It says that we need to let Mueller do his work. I mean, I would argue that both people who support Trump and people who oppose Trump want this thing to wrap up for opposing reasons,
right?
But look, we have to let it play its course.
But to our colleague's point, how long?
Until the investigation ends.
I would have wrapped up this investigation.
We don't know what he has. We don't know what loose ends are.
We don't know what the evidence is.
You're absolutely right. There's no evidence. You investigate the crime, not the criminal. You investigate the crime.
We don't know. You have not talked about Mueller. I have not talked about Mueller. We don't know where his evidence is. We don't know if there's...
He doesn't know where his evidence is.
We just don't know.
That's why we just keep talking about it. Thanks, everybody. This is day 42 of President Trump's administration, and it's also 174 days until the midterm elections. But who's counting? That's the State of America tonight. We'll see you back here tomorrow.